sort of thing you'd find at the beach.
Jackson, Tennessee is a long way from the ocean, but you'd never know it looking at what soil scientist Forbes Walker is digging up. This field is pretty much solid sand, deposited from a nearby creek when it floods. Sand zaps soil nutrients and hurts crop yield. But help is coming in the form of this substance. Biochar is being spread on fields at UT's Ag Research Center with hopes of improving soil fertility.
So what we're trying to do is amend these sand deposits with biochar, increase the water holding capacity, thereby increase the potential for the crops to grow. And then over time, we'll be following these things over time, we should start to see organic matter build up.
This is where UT Ag Research stores a large supply of biochar. It gets its name because it looks like charcoal and is rich in carbon and other nutrients. Biochar is made at this Lebanon plant, where a gasification process creates the substance from materials that would have gone into a landfill. Biochar can be made from tires, biosolid waste, and wood products.
In Tennessee and indeed southwide, we are constantly looking for new markets for wood products, particularly the lower grade products. In other words, hardwood timber that's difficult to sell on the open market. And so biochar is a potential solution for that.
Back on the Knoxville Ag Campus, PhD candidate Nastaran Basiri Jaromi conducts research into mixing biochar with pine bark, sort of mulch on steroids. She then put the substance on greenhouse plants like hydrangeas.
Biochar help the hydrangea plants and reduce the water consumption by at least one third. And it also reduced the amount of leachate, the water that comes out of the pots. So by reducing the leachate, it would also reduce the nutrient losses.
UTIA will put tons of biochar on Tennessee land, grow crops there this summer, and then measure the yields. But before planting, these fields get a renovation, spread the wealth, and the nutrients. This is Charles Denny reporting.